A very good morning to all. This is Monica ma'am, your English teacher. Welcome to the e-classes of Ambuja Public School. Today I will teach you chapter 1, Wonderful Ways of unit 1 from your English textbook, Marigold English Reader. Let us begin the reading of lesson number 1 from unit 1. The title of the story is Wonderful Ways. Once the Maharaja of Travancore ordered a grand dinner in his palace. In the afternoon before the dinner, the Maharaja entered the kitchen to survey the dishes that had been prepared for the feast. "What are you going to do with those vegetable scraps?" he asked the cook, pointing to the basket of scraps near the cook. The cook replied, "They are waste. We will throw them away." "You cannot waste all these bits and pieces of vegetables. Find a way to use them," the Maharaja commanded sternly and walked away. The cook was in a fix and kept staring at the vegetable scraps for some time. Suddenly, an idea flashed across his mind. He took all the vegetable bits, washed them and cleaned them well. Then he cut them into long strips. He put them in a huge pot and placed it on the fire to cook. Next, he ground some fresh coconut, green chilies and garlic together. He added this paste and some salt to the cooking vegetables. A tempting smell started coming from the pot. Now, he whipped some curd and added it to the curry. He also poured a few spoonfuls of coconut oil and decorated the dish with curry leaves. Lo and behold, the new dish was ready. The cook served this new dish to the guests that evening. Everyone was eager to know the name of the new dish. The cook thought and thought. Then a name came to his mind. He named it Avyal. Avyal became famous all over Kerala and is now one of the dishes in a traditional Kerala feast, and imagine, it all came from a basket of waste. So here the story ends. Before proceeding towards the explanation, first let us understand what is waste. So dear children, waste is any substance which is discarded after the primary use, or it is worthless or is defective, that means broken in some way, and if it is of no more use. Or in simple terms we can say, waste is something that is thrown away because it is no longer useful. Some of the examples of waste can be an empty shoebox, used plastic bottles, vegetable or fruit peel, or old newspapers. We generally throw these away, and as a result there are heaps of garbage mounds collected everywhere, thus polluting the environment. Now a big question arises here, how this can be controlled? The answer is simple. Just by changing our daily lifestyle and by using the 3 R's of waste management. The 3 R's are recycle, reuse and reduce. With this solution we can make best out of waste. Likewise, with the vegetable and fruit scraps we can make a tasty stew. Kitchen waste can be used to make organic fertilizers, and the empty shoe boxes or the newspapers can be used to make creative artistic things of art and craft. These are vegetable peels. You all must have seen your mama peeling the vegetables and throwing away the scraps. In today's story, the cook also plans to do the same, but he could not. Let us understand why. This story is a folktale of Kerala. Folktale are traditional stories that pass from one generation to another. These stories stories have fictional characters, but they can easily be related to the real life characters. Folk tales usually begin with the phrase, a long time ago, once upon a time, etc. One more element of folk tales is that they have a theme, a setting of the story, main characters, and there is a problem as well as a solution with the life lesson. This story is a folk tale from Travancore in Kerala. Travancore is now known as Thiruvananthapuram. It is also the capital of Kerala. Wonderful Waste is the story that tells us about the origin of the famous dish from Kerala known as avial. The story is about a cook in a palace who is faced with a dilemma of using up the waste which the king demanded. The theme of the story is recycling of waste. In this story, the king of the place named Travancore is organizing a feast in his palace. He invites all his friends and the kings in the nearby kingdom. He calls the cook of his palace and orders him to prepare the traditional feast with all tasty special dishes for the special guests. Thus, the cook is busy in the kitchen with the preparations for the feast. He peels the vegetables and collects all the vegetable scraps in the basket to throw them away later on. In order to make sure everything is being prepared in full swing, the king decides to go in the kitchen for the inspection. When he pays a visit to the kitchen, there is something odd that catches his attention, and those are the vegetable scraps. He finds a lot of vegetable scraps in a basket which was of no use and treated as a waste. Upon seeing this, the king orders the cook not to waste those scraps. Instead, he commands him to make use of them in a wise manner and goes away. It leaves the cook confused and baffled. Now he does not know what he is going to prepare with the vegetable scraps. The cook was in a fix and kept staring at the vegetable scraps for some time. However, upon thinking hard, he does not reach a conclusion easily. All of a sudden, a rather interesting idea comes to his mind. He takes up all the vegetable scraps and washes them and cleans them properly. He starts cutting them into long strips. After cutting the vegetable scraps into long strips, he took a huge pot, boiled some water and started adding the vegetables into it. He lit the fire and took some coconut, some green chilies, garlic and made a paste of it. Then he added the paste into the boiling pot. A tempting smell started coming when he added some whipped curd into it. He kept on stirring the curry. He also poured spoonfuls of coconut oil and decorated the dish with curry leaves. Lo and behold, the new dish was ready to be served. Look how yummy it's looking. In the evening, when all the guests arrived, this dish was served along with the other variety of food. Everyone was very happy with the new dish. They were so eager to know the name of this variety, the special dish that was prepared by the cook. Now the cook thought, what should be the name of this dish? Something came to his mind and he named it as avial. Everyone enjoyed the dish onwards, the dish avial became the popular dish all over Kerala, and now it is a part of a traditional Kerala feast which once was just a waste. Some new words from the story are, in a fix, this is a phrase, a situation hard to escape from. Palace, a place where the king lives. Traditional means belonging to the custom or culture. Tempting means attractive. And sternly means harshly or in a serious manner. The word commanded means ordered. Survey means to examine or to look closely at. And the last word, lo and behold, means look, what a surprise. In this chapter, we learned the story of avial through a folktale of Kerala. We also learned that we should avoid the wastage of food. And we also learned some new words and phrases. From this story, we also learned that we should recycle the waste as far as possible. Because it is rightly said that either recycle your trash or trash your earth. That means if we will not recycle the waste material, or if we will not reuse or reduce the waste things, we will definitely end up turning our mother earth into a trash bin. So this story concludes here, and it tells us a great deal about recycling and how we can get creative and not let anything go to waste. Moreover, it also takes us into history and the origin of the famous dish of Kerala known as avial. With this, I conclude my today's class over here. We'll meet you soon with the explanation of next unit. Till then, thank you, take care and stay in shape.